Couples who have unexplained infertility have several options for trying to improve their odds of conceiving. These treatments can be used at any age. If you are 35 years old or over, which of these treatments has the highest chance for success? Let's see what the data says. First off, what is unexplained infertility? This is a phrase used to describe patients who have infertility, but all of their testing has come back normal. At a minimum, in order to be diagnosed as having unexplained infertility, a sperm collection should be done to look at your partner to document the presence of numerous moving sperm. On your side, blood tests and ultrasounds should be performed to assess your ovarian reserve, ovulation, and thyroid function, and a hysterosalpingogram should be completed to evaluate the uterus and fallopian tubes. In some cases, testing may also involve looking inside the abdomen for endometriosis or scar tissue. Couples with unexplained infertility can be divided into two groups. Group 1 are people who actually have a specific cause for their infertility. It just hasn't been discovered yet. Doctors are identifying new causes for infertility all the time. We may not know what is causing your infertility today, but we may tomorrow. Group 2 are people that truly don't have anything medically wrong with them, but they have just been statistically unlucky to that point. Given a long enough period of time, many people in this group will get pregnant on their own without treatment. As a fertility doctor, there are a variety of treatments that I can offer to patients to help shorten the time that it takes to achieve a pregnancy. Fertility medications are commonly used for this purpose in order to get multiple eggs to develop. There are two oral fertility medications that can be used for unexplained infertility, Clomid and letrozole. For people with unexplained infertility, Clomid works better than letrozole. I talk about that in this video. In addition to using fertility medication, many fertility doctors will also perform a procedure to get more sperm up into the fallopian tubes. This is known as IUI, or intrauterine insemination. How well does Clomid and IUI work if you are 35 or older? This study is the largest to look at pregnancy rates using Clomid and IUI. In this study, people who were 35 to 37 years old had a pregnancy rate that was just over 9% for each completed Clomid cycle. This means on a given try, about 1 in 11 people this age would become pregnant on a single attempt with Clomid. For patients aged 38 to 40, that rate was a bit lower at 7.3%, or about 1 in 13 people. Another group of fertility medications are given as injections. These are called gonadotropins. These shots can also increase the number of eggs that mature at one time, and can also be combined with an IUI for couples with unexplained infertility. At my fertility center, IVF1, we have treated people with injections of fertility meds and IUI over 800 times in people who were 35 and over. In people aged 35 to 37, the pregnancy rate was 16.7% per try. In 38 to 40-year-olds, it was 15.8%. IVF is also used as a treatment for unexplained infertility. In order to determine the pregnancy rate in older people, specifically with unexplained infertility, we turned to the U.S. IVF database. In their online database, the pregnancy rates are broken down by age. You can also filter the patients based on their diagnosis. We looked at those patients that had unknown factor as their diagnosis and that were attempting pregnancy using their own eggs and did not have chromosome testing of their embryos. For people aged 35 to 37, the live birth rate for a single embryo transfer in 2019 was 30.6%. For 38 to 40-year-olds, it was 19.2%. If the embryos were tested first, then the chance for a live birth was 44% for 35 to 37-year-olds and 35% for 38 to 40-year-olds. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. If you are 35 years of age or older and have unexplained infertility, the treatment with the highest chance for pregnancy is IVF. Embryo testing gives the highest chance. Transferring untested embryos is second best. The third best treatment utilizes fertility injections with IUI. The fourth best is Clomid and IUI. and the least successful treatment is letrozole. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.